click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that is what is chemical equilibrium, and we are going to study about what is dissociation constant for a weak electrolyte. So let us understand it with this lecture.
Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
So now we are going to discuss about the dissociation constant for a weak electrolyte. So whenever we consider a weak electrolyte, we get to know that it dissociates, but it doesn't dissociate completely, and because of which we could see an equilibrium between the product that we could say like the ions that are being obtained from that electrolyte and the original electrolyte that we have taken. And so therefore there would be an equilibrium between this two kind of that is product, or you could call it as this two phases. And that is the reason that we could see that the equilibrium is being maintained between these two, that is the cations or the anions that are being produced and the electrolyte that we have taken. So let me give you a short example of it, that what is actually the weak electrolyte and how does it dissociates. So for example, if I am taking a weak electrolyte generally, suppose suppose Ba, and so it has to undergo dissociation, and so as it will get basically that is a cation. So I have named it as B plus, and an anion that is A minus. If the electrolyte that is B, if it dissociates into B plus and A minus, that is a cation and an anion. But since it is a weak electrolyte, so therefore it will form an equilibrium between this thing. So that's the reason that we symbolize it with this arrows, or this half arrows as we have mentioned over here, and they are basically in a reversible direction. So that is the reason that we will get a particular cation and we'll get a particular anion, and this is the product that we have got over here, that is this is the species that we have got over here from the original electrolyte, and the equilibrium has been maintained. And what we have to do is we have to give the dissociation constant for the weak electrolyte. But before understanding what is dissociation constant for the weak electrolyte, we have got to know that is what is law of mass action. And in law of mass action, we have studied that the equilibrium constant is been the main thing, and which is nothing but it is the ratio of the product of the that is we could also call it as the product of the active masses of the product to the product of the active masses of the reactant. So in this case, if you observe, then this is the one which is acting like a product and this is the one which is acting like a reactant. So therefore, in terms of the equilibrium constant, when we give it for substance which undergo dissociation or the chemical equilibrium, then we give it with the help of a equilibrium constant. So, and also by applying the law of mass action. So therefore, applying law of mass action, we will get to know that is the equilibrium constant is actually the ratio of the product of the active masses of the product. So this is what we have got over here. So the products are basically B plus, and we are multiplying because we need a product of the products. So therefore, this is A minus we have got over here, and in this case the reactant has been like Ba. So therefore, the active masses of or the concentration of the reactant end, that is B. So this is what we have got, and we have got it by applying law of mass action. But since we are talking about weak electrolyte, and weak electrolytes or the electrolytes, they undergo dissociation, and that's the reason that the equilibrium constant that we have written over here will be termed as dissociation constant. Yes, it is very similar to that of dissociation constant and a chemical equilibrium, the both are same, but when we are specifying for a weak electrolyte, we name it as dissociation constant, and this is what dissociation constant is, and it is represented by K. But when it comes to the magnitude of the dissociation constant of a particular electrolyte, so the magnitude of it of a particular electrolyte, that is the dissociation constant for a particular electrolyte, it will be the same at a given temperature for a particular electrolyte only. So that is the reason that because of applying of law of mass action only, we have got this value, and obviously this value won't change, that is the constant value will not change at a particular temperature. And we are talking about a particular temperature because obviously the dissociation, it depends on temperature that we have got to know, that is in the nature of how the temperature will affect the dissociation constant, or how the temperature will affect the dissociation of a particular electrolyte or of a particular reaction. So this is what we have got to know, and this is basically dissociation constant for a weak electrolyte. But talking about the similar thing that we could call it for, that is weak acid as well as weak base, even they act like an electrolyte. So therefore, when it comes to a weak acid, so let me give you a short idea about it. So weak acid, suppose let me generalize it by HA. So suppose if HA is the one which is basically a weak acid, so therefore it will dissociate into, that is H plus and A minus. And since it is a weak electrolyte that we have taken over here, so therefore we could say that an equilibrium can be maintained in this case, where H plus and A minus will be acting like a product, while that of the HA it will act like a reactant. So in this case we'll get to know that is the, if we apply the law of mass action, so we'll get to know that is K is equals to the product of, that is the active masses of the concentration of the products, that is HA into A minus, that is what we have got over here, and divided by, that is concentration of HA. So if we observe, then we'll get to know that the dissociation constant for acid is nothing but the equilibrium constant of a weak acid after applying the law of mass action at a given temperature. So that is what the definition of the equilibrium constant, or the definition of the dissociation constant for the weak acid will be. And that is the reason that because it is representing not an electrolyte, but it is representing an dissociation constant for an acid, so that, and also for a weak acid, so that is the reason that we named it as Ka. So now this is the expression from which we could mention the dissociation constant for a weak acid. So now similarly we can also do it for the dissociation constant for a weak base also. And for base, let me give it that is in this way, that is BOH. And the reason that I have represented the acid by, that is HA, and the base by BOH, the reason behind that is because we have did the Arrhenius concept of acid base, the Lowry-Bronsted concept, as well as we have did that is Lewis concept for acid and base. And in talking about the first one, that is Arrhenius concept, we will get to know that is a compound which consists of H plus, or the compound which consists of hydrogen, but on dissociation it gives H plus ions, are basically known as acid. So that is the reason that we have given a short example, or given a generalized equation for the weak acid that we have given in the previous one. And talking about the weak base, then weak base are basically, or the base are those substances which consist of OH atoms or OH group, and which on dissociation which gives OH minus ion, and that's the reason that they are represented by BOH. And for general one, and suppose if it dissociates into, that is B plus and OH minus. But and again, suppose if it is a weak electrolyte, so therefore there will be an equilibrium that will be maintained over here, and this is what we could get. And by applying the law of mass action, we'll get to know that is the equilibrium constant K is will be equal to the ratio of the product of that is B plus and OH minus, and yes, the reactant in this case basically it is BOH, and yes, we have got over here. And if you talk about the weak base, then this K, or this equilibrium constant that we have got, will be termed as dissociation constant for weak base, and that's the reason that we will name it as KB. And that's it I wanted to explain. So this is the expression where we could generalize the dissociation constant for a weak base, and the definition of it would be very much simple, that is it is nothing but the equilibrium constant when a particular weak electrolyte is in equilibrium at a particular temperature. So that's it. So this were the three things that I have discussed about, that is one was generally for a weak electrolyte, one was for weak acid, and one was for weak base. So this was I wanted to explain. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know new concept about this thing. And I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.